much for having me. This is great. I'm the last person after a long day. But the nicest thing is that you can't ask any questions. So we'll just sit here, listen to what we say, and then have tea and we all go home. I was very confused because we got a lot of instructions about what to do here. And one of the things I did is that I didn't actually talk to anybody because I read the instructions and wasn't sure how you're supposed to just come here and not talk about your work, talk about your story or something. But then yesterday I talked to Satyam and we have a prior relationship, so he has to listen to me. And I said, can I just get up and say a story? And he said, that's fine. So that's what I'm going to do. I think that the listening to all the speakers in front of me, I can see that there are a lot of some very common themes. My story, or the story I'm going to tell, starts with a writing of a paper. How many people here have written papers? Very good. So, in Pratham, we do many things, but we don't write papers very well. And so to get this, there was a conference in Bangalore about 15 years ago. And with great difficulty, I felt that, we should send in a paper. Because, we do all this work and whatnot. So the conference came and went, paper was written. And as with many conferences, it's all very nice, but it's not clear how the paper was connected to whatever. It was sort of your passport to go to the conference. 7 weeks later, I get a phone call from Bihar. I'm from Bihar myself, and this is somebody who had actually read the paper, which was shocking, because most papers are generally read by the authors. And maybe by an advisor if you're still in college. And this person actually read the paper and wanted to have a conversation. The paper was about various things, but also about assessment. And wanted us to come to Bihar and do an assessment. So my question to this person was that, assessment or taking temperature is usually when you expect the temperature will change because of some reason, because of something that you'll do. So what is it that you want to measure? Because if nothing is going to happen, then the measurement is not very interesting. I mean, I was a little more, I'm talking in a sophisticated way here, but I said ki mudde ka temperature leke koi fayda hai nahi. Aapko agar aage iske aage kuch karna hai tab dekhte hain. So I think this shook up this gentleman who was a very nice, polite person, and we decided that this is not a conversation to have on the phone. So two of my colleagues went and to meet him. And they continued on this way to say that we should do a measurement only if there should be a measurement first, then something happens. And then there will be a measurement later. And this was in 2004. It was still Lalu days in Bihar, where education was not hot on anybody's agenda. And, after talking a lot about what possibly in the next few months could happen that could justify a measurement now, so a very convoluted conversation, start somewhere, went somewhere else. It turns out that Bihar government was at the time thinking of recruiting para teachers. Something like 120,000 para teachers were likely to be recruited. So once my colleagues figured out that this is a major thing, in a system which has, in those days, had about 2 lakh or something teachers, bringing in another 1.5 lakh is a fundamental change, which casually came out in a conversation, that perhaps this will happen. So then it makes sense to do something before, and something major will happen, and then do something after. Because presumably, an infusion of this kind of numbers will change the system in some form or the other. And I think that started a whole adventure. I will not bore you with the details of everything that happened. But basically, the government was getting ready for a group of trainers. They were creating about 5,000-6,000 trainers who were then going to be the trainers that trained all these teachers who would come in. And these trainers were, because of whatever reason, these 5,000-6,000 people would be undergoing about a 10-day training in 150 different locations. And so they said that our time is very packed because we already have, we know what we want to do. So if you want to bring in any ideas, there isn't any time. And again, my two colleagues, I think, were very good negotiators, and they said, ki lunch to aap log khate hai na. And then, bahut sare trainings mein lunch is quite long. So we need 1 hour out of that middle part of the day. And it'll actually act as an energizer, because what we want is that people leave the location, go to a nearby school and do some work with kids. Whatever we are saying to you should be happening in training. These trainers will practice it. Because trainers, are very experienced people. They don't need any training. Trainers never need training. It's the trainees who always need the training. And so on. So what happened after this was, the government said, fine, we don't have any money. So if you want to do this, you're very welcome, because it seems like a very different thing that you take people out of a classroom into the field, they will do something and come back. But for that, you'll have to provide people to go along with them. So is it okay? 150 locations simultaneously, so do log, 300 people. And when this discussion was happening, I remember we were having a board meeting. And the chairman of our board was Mr. Wagul, who was then the chairman of ICICI. You know, like a good banker, and he's a very nice gentleman. He said, "What is the big rush? This Bihar, nothing has happened in so many years. Now everybody is scrambling to rush to Bihar. I mean, is this really needed?" Good question. So I said, "Sir, you know, if there is an opportunity, we should go for it." And he said, "But is this an opportunity?" Another big question. So we decided this is these tough questions we'll handle later. But how do you move people across the country? So this was, I think, we must have had email and all by that time. Cell phones to nahi the. So I sent out a message saying, 1 month in Bihar, 3 requirements. You should be able to speak Hindi. You should know the Pratham method, which most people in Pratham luckily did. And you have to ask your parents. Within a few days, I had far more than 300 people who wanted to go. Where is the money coming from is not clear. I mean, there was no money. Many people actually called me to say, "Don't worry, train pe na waise bhi hum ticket nahi dete." And I think that what happened afterwards is the 300 people arrived. Most of the 300 people were well under 25. 50% or more were girls. They were from places as far away as Gujarat, as far away as a Hindi-speaking area of India would go. Where to keep 300 people in Patna when you don't really have any resources? How they should go, and they moved within 3 days to about 150 locations around. In many cases, not just in the districts that they went, but even in the center, there were about 10 people who were holding all of this together. I remember going into meetings where everybody was male, and the only people who were female were the team that arrived. I mean, now when I look back, you know, I think that this was a huge risk to take, but the spirit of it was that everybody was looking for something that was a pretty different adventure. Many things happened after that, and you know, my clock is ticking, so I won't tell you the various things, but I think we learned some very key lessons. One was that there were tough questions being asked of us, but the answers weren't apparent immediately. Second was that conversations, you need to talk and you need to listen, because you never know where any of these will go. And I think the third thing was, to come into this sector or anywhere, I don't think there's anything special about this sector or any other sector, is that a sense of adventure is always very useful. If you define adventure, what is adventure? It is doing something that you haven't done before and you're not entirely clear where it will head. But definitely the one thing that you can be sure of is that there'll be some huge amount of learning. Good learning, bad learning, useful learning, useless learning, can't say. The team that went back, these 300 people, and this happened in 2004. When I look at who is our leadership in different programs today, a large part of it was people who got up and said, "I'm going to do this." Not clear what I'm going to do. Not even sure that most of them had permission from their parents, because later on, we found out that many people had just disappeared for 1 month. But I think that the sense that this is something large, this is something that is an opportunity, and that I need to take it up, and I'll figure out, you know, what happens afterwards. But basically, the fact that I'm going to deal with whatever comes my way, I think was one of the most useful things. I don't think you can have a training program to teach people that. You know, how do you jump into a deep well and learn to swim yourself? All I think I did was to present the well, and then people learned how to swim. Did anything, you know, what came out of this, you know, what did it do for the organization, what did it do for individuals? There are many stories that people tell, but I think what it showed us is that when you decide to do something big together, it is possible. And that given some broad framework, everybody innovates in their own way to maximize what has to be done. So my advice, they asked us on give a sound bite, is what is the advice to people in the sector? This is lovely. Nobody's ever asked me for advice, by the way. Thank you so much. Asking for the advice is to say, have a sense of adventure, this sector or any other sector. And I think when you dive into the adventure, make sure that you're learning something every day. So thank you.